Hey there, Crystal Covington here with one of our amazing members, Jana Axleen. I am here talking to the Chief Project Officer with Project Genetics. It sounds super serious and important. And we've been chatting before we hit record about business development in this pandemic era. So I am very excited to hear from Jana about what her experience has been in kind of maneuvering, remaneuvering, and pivoting as we have had to kind of adjust things. And she's in a very interesting position of being, you know, she's one of our Denverites. And we met here in Denver, Colorado, but she lives in Australia and can talk a little bit about kind of that global perspective and looking at what she's had to do to pivot. So Jana, share a little bit about what's going on.
Well, the pandemic really put a glitch in my plans, as I'm sure many people, because we were actually supposed to live half in the States and half in Australia, going back every quarter. So I haven't been back since February, and it's been really, really difficult for me because, you know, I have a business over there, and obviously every business needs to be nurtured. I have employees, so now I only see them via Zoom rather than our regular, you know, employee appreciation dinners and things like that. So, but I think what's been really important about the pandemic and then relating it back to business development is that any of these type of events that happen, right, because whether it's a pandemic, a recession, a market disruption, we always have to learn how to pivot and agile and be agile in how we do our business, right? And so we've had to really relook at how do we do business development. So Project Genetics is a project management consulting company. We help companies implement technology projects. And so we're used to this working at home or working at the client site, and all of that wasn't much of a change for us. What has been really hard is figuring out how to connect with prospective clients and trying to figure out how to cut through the noise. And I definitely don't have all the answers, but I can. I think it's important to share some of these things that that we've been doing. So we've been going back to basics. Trying to come up with content to get out there on LinkedIn and other social media platforms that really is helpful and isn't saying the same thing as everyone else. So like the one thing I never did post about was how do you work from home or advice from working from home, because everybody was doing that. And that doesn't cut through the noise. So one of the things we've been focusing on is talking to companies about, well, you're afraid to make investments. So how do you save money on the projects that you're currently doing by ensuring that they're being executed efficiently? Right, so how do you get that efficiency? So changing the content that we're putting out so that we're focused on, one, things that can help people, and two, things that other people aren't talking about. So I think everybody can take that away of like, how can I share what I do in a way that cuts through the noise? And the second thing we've been really doing is trying to come up with giveaways that might help people. Here's a free download, because you can put those obviously and get phone numbers that way. And now we have to live in a time where phone numbers are really important, because you can't just, meet people at a coffee shop or show up at the office and deliver them a bag of, cookies or something and get a meeting. You've got to find a way to get in contact. So giving them something really valuable that they will be willing to give a phone number and then maybe have a conversation with us is one of the things we've been trying. And the other thing we've been doing is playing the long game. And so, you know, I did hire a sales guy, and he hasn't gotten any sales, but that's okay. Recently, but what we've been focused on is how do you build that relationship so that when the economy does turn, that we have already provided free value. So going out there, we've been saying, all right, we'll give free health checks on your project and tell you what's going wrong and what can you improve. And there's no obligation. You don't have to sign up with us. But what we're hoping is that we're investing so that 6 months from now, if companies are really ready to reinvest in their projects, they'll be like, oh, these guys helped us they've been our partner. They haven't, you know, pushed us for money. They haven't been all salesy. Instead, they've been just building a relationship. And so that's really what we're focused on, is how do we build those relationships so that at the other end of this, people turn to us for help. And then the final thing we've done, we've been fortunate that our business hasn't decreased. So we've focused on how do we reinvest in ourselves a little to improve, again, some of those basics. So we're about to relaunch our website because, you know, it was something that we put together ourselves, but actually hired somebody this time to do it for us. And just finding opportunities to make investments while things are quiet so that we're prepared should there be a mass increase in sales. So, you know, kind of to recap, I would just, you know, say, how do you differentiate yourself from everyone else? How do you add value, and how can you reinvest in your business so that you can really propel yourself forward?
Those are amazing pieces of advice. I will tell you, I've spent hours listening to other people talk, and it took hours to learn to hear a little bit of what you shared in just those few minutes. So you are the truth here. So a little bit about what is a great connection for you, and how can people keep in touch and share resources and support you?
Well, always loved connecting on LinkedIn. So you can find me there, Jana Axline, AXLINE. If you want to check out our company though, and see our blog and some of our advice, it's projectgenetics.com. Cause I'm out there blogging regularly on how to improve projects and really we're doing project rescue series. So how do you save those failing projects? So, those are the best ways to probably stay in touch.
Okay. Awesome. Thanks so much for taking the time to chat with me. I could chat with you for hours. I have a billion questions. So hopefully, everybody can share those in comments and tag you and talk to you. Yeah. And I wish you, you know, the best in doing all of what you're doing to support businesses and to continue to stand out as a voice.
Thanks. And you know, it was really good to connect with you again and all the content you're putting out there. So I appreciate the positive vibes you're always instilling for the women of Denver. Truly makes a difference.
Thanks, Jana.
Thanks.